The UpFit Integration System hardware module has four connectors. Connector 1 provides power to the module from the vehicle battery. Connector 2 provides access to the higher power 10 amp and 5 amp outputs, including two pairs of 5 amp half bridge outputs. Connector 3 provides lower power pulse width modulation capable outputs, digital inputs, and analog inputs. And the fourth connector communicates with the vehicle and provides the vehicle signals to the module on the UpFitter J1939 bus. If the module is fitted at the factory, connectors 1 and 4 are already connected. Connectors 2 and 3 are provided with blunt cuts, ready for UpFitters to connect equipment. Instructions on how to connect to the UpFitter J1939 bus are provided in the latest BBLB or Q bulletin in North America, or the BEM in Europe. In the UIS connector tab, you can select from connector 2 for the high power outputs and connector 3 for the other inputs and outputs. The pinout of the connector on the module can be seen at the top of the panel. If you hover over different outputs on the list, the correct pin is shown on the connector for ease of identification. You can also filter the list of outputs to show only the pins currently being used. The outputs can be configured by double-clicking on the output while it's in the list to bring up the settings panel. You can name the output here, which is recommended to make your project easier to read. Reactivation attempts determines the number of times the module will try to enable the output before returning an error to the user. For the high power outputs, this gives you the option to choose between a constant output or a simple pulsed output. If you choose a pulsed output, you can configure the pulse cycle and the pulse duration. This type of pulsing is suitable for basic applications like flashing lights on and off. But the PWM-capable outputs on connector 3 should be used for more precise high-speed pulse control. You'll also see that we can configure the open load current threshold. The default is the minimum value of 1500 milliamps, but can be increased by typing in the box. This value is used to determine whether a load is detected on the output pin. You will see that we already have the logic to provide a true value if either the can frost warning occurs or the driver presses the passenger heater button on the sync screen. You want to turn on a hardware output when both of these conditions are true. So if you drag the heater output onto the canvas, you can complete the logic to turn the output on. Now you need to set the status of the sync screen button. You can use the connector block to monitor the status of the output you created, and you can set the sync screen button to match the output by connecting the two together. You can only create one instance of the connector output. A status block will be created if you drag the connector onto the canvas a second time. You will see that you can monitor various other statuses of the connector by using the dropdown on the status block. Stuck and overloaded provide statuses based on electrical measurements taken across the output relay. Half-bridge outputs offer similar statuses to the high-power outputs, with additional statuses to monitor the polarity of the bridge and whether either side of the half-bridge is stuck. On connector 3, you'll find the PWM outputs as well as the digital and analog inputs. The PWM frequency is configured programmatically, so if we want to set a PWM frequency and duty cycle, we can drop down a constant logic block and set the values we want. Digital inputs can operate in switch or push-pull mode. Switch works like your household light switch and will stay high while the input is high and revert to low when the input goes low. Push-pull mode works more like the start-stop button in a vehicle, where the first press activates and the second press deactivates. The first time a digital input is tracked onto the canvas, the discrete status can be monitored. The second time it's added, it will provide the inverted state. Finally, Analog inputs provide a way of bringing analog sensor data, like a temperature sensor, into your project. The inputs are 0 to 20 volt and can be configured by double-clicking on the input in the list. This allows you to name the input signal and also decide whether to enable thresholding on the signal. You can configure multiple thresholds for the signal, and each threshold provides a discrete status. When you add the signal to the canvas the first time, we get the analog voltage value. Adding it a second time gives you a number of statuses that you can monitor, including thresholds. These thresholds operate in a running point manner, so only the threshold band that a signal is currently within will provide a true output. You can also get a filtered version of the signal as well as a relative value which displays the voltage as a percentage of full scale. For example, 10 volts would equal 50%. The digital inputs and the first analog input can be used to wake up the module. Ford Pro continues to work toward even more smart, helpful, and innovative solutions to help improve your business. Any questions? Visit this site for more information or email fpsvhelp@ford.com in the EU.